everyone. Welcome to Land and Sea. I'm Jane Adey. Did you get out trouting this season? Wildlife officers love to see lots of people out enjoying the ponds and lakes in Newfoundland and Labrador. So as soon as the trouting season opened this past spring, we headed out to the west coast to a place known for big fish. The west coast town of Howley has a strong connection to these big, hungry herbivores. Moose were first introduced to Newfoundland here 120 years ago, way back in 1904. The community is proud of that part of its wildlife heritage. And come springtime, there's another reason Howley is on the map for outdoor enthusiasts.
Nice.
You gotta put in there for me.
Trout. This spot is known as the Howley Narrows, a gorgeous sandy stretch on Grand Lake that Roland Lachlan knows well. He was born in Howley. Roland is 82 and still casting his line out in hopes of a nibble.
It's been a great place to fish, and we're lucky to have such a good place. But all these fellas, now they'll know where to go fishing if this goes on TV. But that's all right with me.
Not a bite.
Linda Hartson and her husband have been trouting here together since they got married. They live in Cornerbrook, but always make their way to Howley for the Victoria Day weekend.
I just love being just out in the air and just being out in the country and just the peace and the tranquility of it. And it's just, you know, like if the sun should happen to shine, we can get our vitamin D as well. So there's health benefits.
The scenery is stunning. But most here barely look up from their rods. They've got their eye on the prize. And as Linda can tell you, when it comes to trouting, size matters.
Because everybody can't wait for the season to open so that we can try to see if we can't catch the big fish. We've caught them 2, 3, 4 pound, especially the winninish. They're so big, and if you can get them big enough, they're so pink, they're so delicious when you cook them.
Those winninish that Linda mentioned are landlocked Atlantic salmon. They're genetically the same as salmon that go to sea, but generally don't grow to be quite as big. And anglers are allowed to catch them with a trout license. Jacob Keefe is hauling one in there now.
Flicking ashore, man.
I'm keeping him.
That's the biggest landlock you ever caught?
Yeah, biggest one I've ever
caught. Is it?
Out of nowhere, dude.
20-year-old Jacob, 20-year-old Braden Kosh,
1.8 pounds.
And 19-year-old Matt Barney are fishing buddies.
Nice.
We'll round up for you.
Yes.
And the Howley Narrows is one of their favorite places to try and snag some trout. They've all had rods in their hands since they were small boys.
Trouting started as a passion for me. I can remember it. I was in grade one, and me and my father were up to a pond called Lance Ajabo Pond up in southern Labrador, just outside of Lanceloo. And I remember we walked around to the brook in the pond, and we did very well, even though they're only little tiny trout about that big. It was me in grade one that it was the most fun that I could ever have in my life. And now it's just every day. Every day the season's open.
Oh, that's a nice trout.
There's nothing more I enjoy than catching a fish. When you hook into a fish, you never know, so you just get a huge adrenaline rush. And then when you land the fish, your adrenaline rush gets even bigger. So it's always a feeling that you're trying to chase. You're always chasing the feeling of catching a fish.
Good. The anglers chase trout and winninish. As Braden explains, the trout and winninish are chasing fish too, much smaller prey that live in Grand Lake.
There's a run, I guess you could call it, where the smelt come in.
In the springtime, the smelt sprint through the narrows.
It's my favorite time to fish it. And that's about, your opening day, May 15th, and it can last anywhere from 2 weeks to a month probably. And that's my favorite time to come fish it, because they're easy to catch.
Matt says the trick is to let the lure follow the natural flow of all the fish in this part of the Narrows.
Well, right now, where I'm just casting and letting it go with the current here, I just have a little imitation smelt on, is what it is. So all it's doing is just going down with the current, and I'm keeping a strain against it. And that's what I find the salmon especially like.
These three are thrilled the season has finally opened.
During the winter, I'm itching to come out here.
The limit is 12 fish, and little ones less than 20 centimeters must be thrown back. Matt is grateful for the limitations. He wants to see lots of fish around for future generations. And he can't understand why more people his age aren't getting out for trout now.
Throw away your video game and appreciate it. Your phone makes you content laying in your bed doing nothing. You know what I mean? So I don't understand why you'd be on your phone instead of being out here on the glass calm lake with two of your best buddies. You know what I mean?
Linda Hartson feels the same way about her peers. For Linda, there's no better way to spend a day.
I'd like to see more people our age get out of the house, enjoy the outdoors instead of staying in the house. Because we're not here for a long time. We're here for a short one. So get out and enjoy.
Guys, have a look at this now.
Wildlife officers are keen to see people of all ages enjoying the outdoors too. We'll hear more about the benefits and learn a lot more about trout when we come back. It's Victoria Day weekend, and trouters at Howley Narrows are trying their luck. Lots cast from the shoreline. Others, like our friends Matt Barney, Jacob Keefe, and Braden Kosh, are casting from the water. Trouting by boat is one way to catch fish. Years ago, anglers in Newfoundland found a great bit of fun trouting by train.
We're on a fishing trip, fishing junction.
The Trouter Special was a route put on each May 24th weekend. Travelers could stop along the tracks at favorite fishing holes and spend some time in the open air. When their worms were gone and their baskets filled, they'd hop back on the train. Getting out into the country offered the same benefits back then as it does today. Yet there are fewer people taking up rods and reels. 30 years ago, the number of active anglers in Newfoundland and Labrador was around 135,000. 10 years ago, the number had dropped by 25,000 and is probably even lower today. And the average age of anglers has risen from 36 years to 52 years.
Toads running by.
Nathan Spence appreciates the chance to take in all that nature has to offer. He and his sons enjoy the sights and sounds at this pond near Cornerbrook on the west coast. There are loons, fragrant blooms, and at this time of spring, the sounds of toads fill the forest. Being outdoorsy isn't just a hobby for Nathan. He works with Newfoundland and Labrador's Wildlife Division and knows a fair bit about our province's freshwater fish.
We have a brook trout, which is our most common native species here on the island.
To know if you've reeled in one of these, look closely at markings on the skin.
So if you see these blue halos that are around those red spots, that's telling that it's a brook trout. The general pattern with the red and blue spots.
Nathan says these brookies, as they're often called, also have a kind of worm-like pattern on their backs. Brook trout spawn in the fall, and their eggs hatch in the spring.
And you can actually see last year's young here. You can see the little guys in these little streams. This is where they'll hang out for this summer because they're prone to predation because they're so small. So they hang out in these little sort of tributary creeks and streams around the ponds. But it usually takes them 3 or 4 years before they're mature enough to spawn and repeat that cycle.
Brooks aren't the only trout angler's net on the island. Brown trout were introduced on the Avalon Peninsula from Scotland way back in 1884, one of the first introductions in North America. Today, browns are found on the East Coast and as far as central Newfoundland. Their sides are yellowy brown with black brown and rusty red spots. A rainbow trout is known for a pink or red stripe on its sides. That strain of fish came from California in 1887. These fish have been swimming around the Avalon Peninsula ever since. When it comes to the size of trout, Nathan says that varies right across the province.
That is very regionally specific. If you fish in around a lot of the popular areas, like in on the Avalon, when you start getting into 8-inch, 10-inch trout, you've got something worth talking about. They're nice. But if you move into some of the areas that have larger strains of fish, like there's some in around Indian Bay, Jonathan's Ponds, those sorts of systems, you can get fish that are growing up to this like 3-4 pounds, which is a notable fish to anybody. If you're in parts of Labrador, you'd expect to see them 4, 5, 6 pounds.
And then there are some brook, brown, and rainbow trout that take an extra long journey to seek out food. Sea trout are the real whoppers.
When they get to a certain age, they go out to sea, they feed heavily because there's a lot of food availability in the ocean, and then when they come back to the stream, they're put on a lot of weight, they're bigger fish.
Whatever fish they're casting for, and no matter the size, avid trouters usually have at least a favorite spot or two.
Well, the big thing for trouting for me is usually around about Labor Day weekend every year.
Monster.
We make a family excursion and we go up the Northern Peninsula and we do very well on trout usually. I'm not telling you where because it's top secret.
Nathan might be tight-lipped when it comes to advice about where to trout. But when you ask him about why families should trout, he's happy to share what he knows. He hopes more parents get their kids hooked on the outdoors.
Start them young. My kids started, oh my goodness, I don't know if they could walk when they started coming in the woods with me. Not only is it relaxing to be out in the country, if you can get your kids, your wife, your family involved, and it becomes even more important because it's a bonding activity that your kids feel like they can open up to you. You've got quiet, there's no electronics buzzing, there's no world buzzing around you. You're here listening to the toads, watching the loon, seeing the duck swim by, catching a trout or two. So it gives you an opportunity to connect, I think, on a different level.
Little guys are chasing us.
Yeah.
The blue fox spinner, so Jacob.
When we come back, we catch up with Matt Barney and Jacob Keith and head into one of their favorite ponds. There's a quiet fishing hole near Pasadena on Newfoundland's west coast. Moose Pond, it's called. Properly named, it seems. At least one has left its mark.
A little breeze. It's windy out. Not serious, though. Not even mad about the wind.
It's a favorite spot for friends Matt Barney and Jacob Keefe. They let Land and Sea tag along for their day in the woods. It's Victoria Day weekend, and that little breeze keeps the black flies at bay. Trees dormant all winter get ready to unfurl their leaves. The toads are here too. Energized by the water's chill, they send out mating trills. Clearly, love is in the air. Matt has a deep fondness for Moose Pond.
I've been coming here for quite some time. My dad showed me this pond when I was small. It's good to get back in here. It feels nice and a lot of memories in here. I've never been here and there's someone else here. So it's very nice. Well, you come to get away from people. Jacob's all right.
And Jacob, he's always game for a day on a pond.
Even when you catch the little ones, still exciting?
Oh yeah, it's always fun. Just at least be getting something. I'll take a little one over nothing any day.
Might have to put on a heavier lure, Jake.
The breeze has turned into full-on wind. The lop on the pond makes it a little hard to fish. Still, the young trouters are up for the challenge using a time-tested tool.
Red devils. Or some people call them Tasmanian devils. But they're just a red and white with a silver back on a spoon. You hear tell of every Newfoundlander, they use a red devil. Like, it's the most common lure in Newfoundland, so I guess they realize that it works in all the ponds and they stuck with it.
The wind might be blowing their chances of catching a big one, but Matt's just happy to be in the woods.
It's very clearing of the mind. It's very easy and nice and peaceful. You don't really think about much. You just take it all in.
Being outdoors is how he wants to spend his days off and his days on.
From a very young age, I've always wanted to be a conservation officer. And fortunately, I got accepted to schooling for the program. And it would be my dream job to have.
Indoor schooling will be important, but his outdoor classroom is where he learns the most.
Avid rabbit snare and grouse hunter. I love salmon fishing. I love fly fishing. That's what I guide. And I like skidoo. I like cutting firewood too, as weird as it sounds. It's pretty enjoyable. And yeah, there's not much that I don't do out here. So anything that you can do, I definitely do. Most people now weren't raised like how me and Jacob were. So when I was growing up, all I ever knew was go fishing or go hunting. But most people don't do that anymore. So they had no one to show them. And it's not something that you can learn it on your own, but you'd want someone to show you at first. But if you don't have anyone to show you, then you're not going to get into it.
Matt would like to see more people enjoy what Newfoundland and Labrador has to offer, and he'd like to see a lot more respect for the great outdoors.
One thing I'm always doing is picking up litter. It's not very good because it kind of ruins it all. You'd have the beautiful pond and then the beautiful hills and then the nice sky, and then you turn around behind you and then there's Tim Hortons cups. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense. It doesn't make me feel very good, and I try to pick up as much as I can when I'm out here. I picked up car bumpers, I've picked up the inside door frame of the car, water jugs, broken cases of beer, anything that you can name, I've picked up.
Both Matt and Jacob worry that people who leave garbage in the woods are the same kind of people who take more fish than they're allowed.
I don't know what the point is. Like, most people are never gonna eat more than the limit anyway. And you come out the next day and get a few more if you want. Or if you want to keep fishing, you can catch and release. I just don't see what you're really gaining by coming out and taking all the fish, or more than you should.
As good stewards of the land, before they go, Matt and Jacob give Moose Pond a tidying up.
Not a bad day.
No, that was a good one. Well, for me, I don't know about you.
They leave with a couple of trout, a bag of garbage, and thoughts of more trouting days to come. Back at Howley Narrows, 82-year-old Roland Lachlan is glad to see younger generations getting out to the ponds and lakes. He encourages everyone to play by the rules.
I hate to come down and see people that are over limit, which hurts. Save something for the youngers coming up. I have my time at it, but I still got great-grandchildren.
Roland knows his own trouting days are precious now.
I had a lot of fun up here. It's a great place. And I told my wife, take my ashes and spread them around.
He's grateful for every cast he's had over the years, chasing the big ones here at Howley Narrows.